Dude, get over yourself. How many times have you heard someone say that to you? Get over yourself. Well, they're actually quoting Catholic doctrine, or a Catholic spirituality, where we learn to have a certain disinterest in who we are. And today we got John Leonetti, who's written the book, The Art of Getting Over Yourself. We'll be right back with a Bear Wozniak adventure.
Welcome to the Bear Wozniak adventure. Kickstart that engine and roll thunder with the pack. Explore the grittiness of manly spirituality. Gain traction in the virtues. Soup up your spiritual engine by turning adversity into adventure. Now here's Bear Wozniak. Let's ride.
Tell me about putting that to the test in the context of a family.
Yeah, it's one thing to say it. It's another thing to actually live it, right? This is the hardest thing you'll ever do. Christianity is not for wimps. Catholicism is not for wimps. I'm allergic anymore in this day to this kind of warm and fuzzy Catholicism. Gospel of prosperity doesn't work, folks. It does not work. You read the gospel. You are reading the wrong gospel, or the gospel of you, not the ones that we see in our gospels when we think that this is all about me getting what it is that I want, more money, more fame, all that sort of thing. So what does the gospel do? Is it rids us of ourselves? Where do we start? Where do we plug in? I think we do it in our families. I mean, that's what our families have to be. They are models of God's love. They are a microcosm of God's love. They are the domestic church. It is a church in your family, in your marriage right now. Revealing to the world what God's love looks like.
We're talking with John Leonetti. John, tell us more. We were about to talk about the dark night of the soul and what that has, how God uses that to help us get over ourselves. Your book, The Art of Getting Over Yourself.
Well, I want to go back to what you said about Aquinas. In your prayer, experience sounded really interesting because it was a lot like Aquinas. I don't want to put you on that level yet, but
wasn't he translated into heaven?
He had a vision. He had some sort of vision. We don't know exactly what it is, but many have commented that it was the beatific vision of Almighty God and all of his glory. And it was 2 weeks before he died, a few weeks before he died, and he didn't write anything after that. We know that for sure. And when he was asked about that, what it is that he saw, he mentioned that everything he's written, we're talking about Thomas Aquinas here, the greatest,
smartest man that ever lived.
Yeah, I mean, the greatest contributor to philosophy and theology.
Hey, man, I don't want you to miss out on your free stuff at deepadventure.com. Go there and subscribe to our weekly email newsletter. You get free video content, including the Bear Wozniak radio show, video version on YouTube before it even airs on EWTN. And you can follow us on all of our social media. Go to deepadventure.com and subscribe. Get your free stuff. And if you're watching on YouTube, don't forget to press the subscribe button and ring that little bell. Don't miss out.